What's up, everybody? It's Chuck with Nerd House. So, if you hadn't noticed from the thumbnail or the title, or for some reason you just found this video by randomly, blindly, blah, 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 out there somewhere, you have discovered I am doing the rapper Dax. And this is his song called Suffocating. And I gotta tell you right now, if you don't know who Dax is, you're sleeping. You need to wake up. Dax is on fire. This guy, for me, he's one of the best improving artists over the last, I'd say, 2 years, 2.5 years, something like that. When I first discovered Dax, it was through another YouTube commentator, reactor, whatever you want to call him, No Life Shack. I'm sure he's got like 2.5 million subscribers. I'm sure some of you know who No Life Shack is. And I started seeing some videos that Dax was doing through him. He was doing, like, remixes and stuff. Well, they call them remixes, but it was a lot of him rapping over, like, Eminem's beats or Dr. Dre's beats or Drake's beats or whatever. I don't know who all he's done. I might have pulled Drake out of my ass. I don't know. Anyway, he just released an actual full-length album. It's not just one-off videos anymore. Like, he's actually got a full album out. And I believe, I could be wrong, I know he did a video with Tom McDonald right before the video, or before the album dropped, but I believe this is his first video from the album. Now, I knew it was coming out today, but unfortunately I had to work, so this is my first chance to get to it, so that's, you know, my hair looks like shit, it's late at night, I'm wearing my my chef's coat from work, like, you know, whatever. So, if I don't look my best, forgive me, that's not why I'm here. I don't give a shit about how I look right now. The important thing is I'm here to check out Dax and his bars. And this dude's got bars. That's all I can really say. So having said that, let's get into this. I love what Dax has to say. I like what he does. I like the different personalities that he brings out. So let's get into this. This should be interesting. And please do me a personal favor. If this is your first time hearing Dax, go listen to more Dax. This dude, he deserves your attention. He deserves your, you know, listening. He's everything that's good about hip-hop today. You know, there's a lot of people out there, the mumble rap and this, that, and the other. They're saying things just to say things, or they're flowing because it rhymes well, so that means it's a good rap. No. This dude has something to say. He says it well. He's... obviously, his rhyme ability is crazy. He can, you know, do the fast rap stuff. He can actually, like, when he does some of those remixes, man, he says things that I actually have to stop and rewind it and go, wait, did I just hear what I thought I heard? Because that's off the hook. You know, to quote Meatwad from Aqua Teen Hunger Force, remove the chain, because that's off it. So, all right, let's get into this, and let's go.
Number one album in the world. I told you to trust me, and now we got it. Dax, you're probably out celebrating right now. Give me a call when you can. We have to get that contract signed. You don't have to read it. I've gone over everything. And remember, for tonight at the talk show, keep it light, keep it positive. Nobody wants to hear anything negative and this sad shit. Your life is about to be changed, brother. I'll talk to you soon. Sign that contract.
Nice. For a second, I thought he had, like, those, I thought he had those, like, hooks in his back, like, you see the people, like, suspended, you know? I was just like, what the fuck? But then I realized it was the knives in his back, like, all the people backstab, oh, that's, I'm telling you. Shout out to Eden G.
Hold my breath. And let all the pressure and anxiety build up. And just let the time pass by. At first I couldn't breathe, now I'm suffocating. Maybe the pressure from the fame isn't worth what I'm chasing. I don't know. I used to say God's playing, now the devil's on my team acting foul and it's all flagrant. Trying to push me off the path that I'm steady paving. Sin is the currency and every day I'm making payments. I don't want to live in it, but I heard a saying, good knows evil because the house is...
Oh my God. Like... Let's go. Let's go.
I'm both adjacent. I don't know if I should go for these goals. I've seen people gain the world but lose their souls. My anxiety is building as the weight of it grows. I seclude myself in privacy inside my home. And I barely answer calls. And when I see my phone, I'm reminded that the real feeling of being alone is having millions who love you but can leave you or say that they hate you at the moment they don't fuck with a song. I used to laugh it off. Now I hold my breath and suffocate. Then I sit and wait just to see if I can kill the hate. And as I'm fleeting, I see God at the heaven's gates and come back down to fight another day. Then I grab that same phone and smile and wave and pour my empty heart into a song that they won't praise. They say patience is the key, but they didn't tell me. While I wait, I'd be locked inside a steel cage. Something's wrong. I feel claustrophobic. I'm stuck living in the past, not the moment or the future where my life is.
I don't know, this actually hits me in a lot of ways, especially that right there about, like, the living in the past, man. Last, I don't know, 18 months or so have been very rough for me personally, and I don't need to get into that. It's nothing you need to worry about. I'm okay. I'm moving past it. I'll be all right. But, that living in the past stuff, man, yeah, like, lately that seems to be all I've been doing is just going over things that I've done and how I wound up in the situation I'm in now, and it's like, that hurts, man, that hits, yeah, this is good.
Only more broken, cause those wounds from the past are still open. I take sips of love and every single time it's poison. I see women who can't see past my employment or see me as enjoyment, so I can't enjoy it cause the ride's temporary and they leave once they crash and destroy it. I don't think this life is healthy. Why didn't anybody tell me? Everybody'd want help, but nobody wanna help me. I'm an ATM, a therapist, and everybody's friendly, and they hide their real intentions, but my mind won't let me. If I make a sad song, don't ask me if I'm happy. Fuck a hook, my pain isn't catchy. If you relate or worse, feel badly. Fucking painting me at least and check in if you at me. That's the only way I know who it touches. That's why I stay awake and answer DMs by the hundreds, so I don't lose myself and fill my stomach with the feeling that I'm here just to suffocate for nothing. If you know real pain, then you see it when you look me in my eyes. I try to hide it, but they do not lie. I wanna sleep, but if I try, the demons who creep in my dreams will collide. So I stay up and I stare at the ceiling, and that's myself.
When he talked about that, you know, the real pain, and you can see it in my eye, like, there's a lot of us out there that we're hurting, and we know that's not going to help anybody. Like, our pain doesn't help you, so we stuff it down, we push it down, and we go out, we put on the happy face, we go out and smile, and everything's fine, everything's beautiful, but it's not. Inside, you know, we're a storm raging, we're hurting, we're lost. And sometimes it takes somebody else to say it before you realize that that's where you're at. And that's part of why I do these videos. I tell people I'm doing it because it's my hobby, but honestly, a lot of it is because I don't have anything else right now. You know, I'm just sitting here alone in my bedroom, just talking to a phone. That's what I'm doing right now. I'm talking to my cell phone. There's nobody on the other end of this while I'm taping this or filming this or whatever you want to call it, you know. I'm looking forward to you seeing it later. I would like to hear what you have to say, but this isn't a conversation that we're having. I'm talking to nobody. There's nobody here, you know. And that's a lot of why I do these videos, is it just helps to have somebody to talk at. Not even talk to, you know, just to do it. But this is deep, man. This is hitting me on a seriously emotional level. I didn't think it would. And honestly, if I wasn't on film, I'd probably be crying right now. You can probably hear it in my voice. Like, I'm kind of fucked up from this. I didn't expect this from Dax. I mean, I knew he was deep and all, but this hits me in a real personal way. So we got about 20 seconds of the song left, so let's finish this up and then we'll move on from there.
If I should even share these feelings, then I hear a voice in the distance from a ghost-like image say my pain could be somebody's healing. So I close my eyes and drift to the place that inspires these lyrics. And as I see flames and I scream, I pray it's a place you'll never have to visit.
Amen. Let's see if I can get this thing to stop now. Okay. I don't have words, man. That really... Whew. The pain that he shows in that song is I relate to that a lot, because like I said, I mean, you know, a lot of us have this hurt from whatever it is. It doesn't matter where it comes from. We all hurt for different reasons, but the important thing is we find healthy ways to get it out, and that's part of why I do these videos. Like I said, like I hadn't mentioned it before because it's not really... It's not important in the context of these videos. You know, the reason why I'm doing these doesn't really matter nearly as much as I hope you're enjoying them. That's the real bottom line. I want you to have a good time. I want you to feel like you're hanging out with me. That's the whole reason why I call this channel the Nerd House, why we're the Nerd House Party. It's because I don't want you to feel alone out there. You're not alone. I'm with you. Maybe only for, you know... What is this, 12 minutes right now while you're watching this video? But for that time, I'm with you. And I got you. And when you guys comment on these videos, when I see these things that have been said, for example, the baby metal video I did, even the people who have said not, I don't know how to say it right, because it's not, nobody's been really negative to me, but the people that have reached out to me and said something to me about the way I presented whatever it was, it's all been very positive. There was one person that was kind of snarky, but other than that, it's been very positive. And I'm not even mad at that person that was snarky. They were just trying to, you know, do their thing. I'm not mad at them. But it's been so nice having these interactions with you. And I'm sure most of you aren't going to watch this whole thing. We're already at like 13 minutes. Nobody wants to watch all that. And if you don't watch this video, that's fine. I'm not upset with you. You know, you're always welcome in the Nerd House Party. But listen, if you're hurting, if you've got problems, if you've got something on your chest that you need to let out, if you got something inside that's causing you pain, get rid of it. Let it go. It's not good to keep that. And it's hard. Don't get me wrong. I understand that. Like, I mean, it's hard to heal that hurt. But for me, things like this are my therapy. And I'm glad to have it. I hope you can find your outlet. And if you need to just blow off some steam, you know what? The comments on this video, this is the place to do that. I don't care. I'm not going to judge you. I'm not going to question you, and I hope none of you do either. Like, just if you've got something on your chest and you need to let that out, this is your place to do it. Do it right down there in the comments. Just say, hey, you know, my boss is an asshole and I hate him, or my mom, you know, smacked me too many times, or whatever it is. I don't care. It doesn't matter. Even if it's something that you think most people are going to think is insignificant, and it doesn't matter if it's, you know, I stubbed my toe in the shower today, I don't give a shit. If it's something that's bothering you, let it out. We'll move forward together, okay? having said all that and having taken up so much of your time, if you've stuck with me through this video, God, you know, you're amazing. I almost said something ridiculous there. I almost said God bless you, and I'm not a believer, so I mean it would be a hollow statement for me to say that. But thank you. Absolutely thank you for sticking with me. And just know that we're only going one direction. From this point forward, we only go one way. And that's to the top. We ain't messing around. This is the Nerd House Party. It's the greatest party that has ever been on this planet. And we're going to rock it until this whole thing is jumping with us. So if you're down with that, come on in. All you got to do is 1, 2, 3, like, comment, subscribe, and you're in the party with me. And we will go forward, upwards, excelsior, to quote Stan Lee. Peace. Nerd House out.